This is Yuri Suzuki, and thank you for like inviting TCD's conference. And my practice is always kind of like one more time, I think. Hello, this is Yuri Suzuki, and thank you for invitation for TCD's conference. And today's presentation, I mainly want to talk about my practice, because my practice is kind of really complicated, because I'm doing quite a lot of different things, like such as art, and also product design, and also art direction, and directing video as well. But always like centered with music and sound, that's key of my practice. And through this conference, I want to like audience to like hear about my observation about music and the sound, and kind of try to think about the importance of the sound design in the public space as well. So that's something like I expected the audience to hearing about.
My name is Yuri Suzuki, and thank you so much for invitation for like a Creative Unfold conference. And as so many of my friends and also some artists and designers respect, it's kind of participate this conference and it's really honored to be here. So I'm kind of like actually working on quite different category, like not only like sound design on the sound art, and also working as kind of bit more commercial work as well, like directing video sometimes, and making installation, and sometimes I'm positioned as more about the educator, and also designing workshop as well for the children. So, but everything like I'm fascinating, and also like kind of main material I'm using on sound and music. And then like, as kind of complication of my practice, probably kind of I can describe about how developed my practice from chronological order. Probably you've seen this guy like last year, Mr. Masamichi, Nobumichi Tosa, I'm really sorry. And I have been working for him for like more than 5 years as a Meiwa Denki. And in the beginning, I was more about engineering or a designer. And in the end, it became like kind of performer as well. So I used to like dancing and singing with like Meiwa Denki. So this is from 10 years ago, like it's me. And it's kind of surprising it's 10 years ago, and I used to play a kind of like rhythm box, like it's Koi beat. And this is actually a concert in Paris. Like we've seen so many different countries like doing concerts and kind of exhibitions too. And that was 2004, and I decided to leave Meiwa Denki because I wanted to develop my own practice. And my first career is like a DJ, and I moved to Berlin, and I tried to establish as DJ, but unfortunately I wasn't really popular. Even like I released a couple of records, but basically nobody buy it. And then like I decided to be like a bit more like far away from music industry, but I still have the passion for the music and sound. So I decided to study design at Royal College of Art, and that's why I moved to London after that. And I just like showing my final project at Royal College of Art, and it's just a truly amazing college like when I studied there. And then like it's kind of just can do anything you want, and it's so much a creative like kind of space for me, and kind of experiment so many different things. And something I wanted to try, it's kind of try to bring my previous career as DJ and the kind of musician and bring it into the design field. And this final project called Physical Body of Sound. So I found this advertisement on the underground in the tube, in the metro in London. It's keep her happy, store all my record to storage. So that time, like people like tend to diminish like a record because taking so much space, and then like basically quite heavy as well. And just like people start to get rid of like physical media at that time. And then that was kind of like an initial topic to like any DJ to discussing or arguing about it all the time, like which media is better to play as a DJ. Some DJs say that kind of record vinyl is better, and some DJs say CD, and some people play from computer as well. And I'm really fascinating about kind of like what kind of like a media exists in this world. And something happened to me, like when I moved from like Japan to like Europe, like it's almost impossible to bring my whole record collection because almost like 2,000 records in my like kind of in the house in Tokyo, and that's impossible to bring it. So what I have done is kind of actually record it and dataizing it and put as an MP3 to my hard drive. And actually, like I think drop off like my hard drive, I lost whole data. Like my collection, like of music. So that time I have got 471 gigabytes of music, and if you play like whole time, like it's 240 days, the length of the sound. So that's what kind of really scared me a lot, because this is kind of like music and sound, and also like a photo and also movie, it's kind of heritage into the future. So we had to kind of keep us really definite and really solid like media. And then like I decided to make one project called Physical Body of Sound. So basically, Physical Body of Sound consists of five or six different like kind of sometimes like a toy and it looks like musical instruments. And it's all designed to like something like kind of kind of under 16 years old people, because under 16 years old people never touch records. So I tried to design entrance into the kind of physical media as a record. And I'm just showing one project because not so much time left for like this like a presentation. It's one project called Sound Chaser. So this is Sound Chaser. It's actually working as a record player. So it's basically Sound Chaser has got, in the bottom has got stylus and the motor, and the top has got speaker and amplifier. And then what I've done is I'm chop up record like this, like it looks like kind of jigsaw puzzle, and making like a laser track, like skeletonic track. And then, and what I've done is this like a device running on top and creating like a different, you can actually physically compose music. Kind of every 45 degrees has got different sound, so you can actually physically make something music. And also this fine element is quite important, because I really want to that kind of treat like a younger generation easy to touch and record as a culture. A long time ago, it's like almost 10 years ago. Yeah. And then it's kind of, this is more about kind of concluding as like my final degree, like try to combine like physical presence of the sound and kind of doing installation. And that's kind of like making like my artist practice as well. And after that, I'm more about kind of creating like series of like objects, kind of more about playback also like vinyl, and how to play in the quite interesting alternative way to playing like vinyl record. Then like, I'm more about considering an initial topic, how we can save like data into physical presence. And then like this is amateur music productions collaboration project with Jazzy Seymour. He's a really amazing designer based in like Berlin, and he's always like using like plastic material which can melt under 60 degrees and easy to melt and easy to attach to the material. And if you can make a construction like a chair or like architecture structure, it's quite strong and you can like use permanently. And he came up with an idea to creating record based on this material, and I just kind of tried to think of a system. So I had like a collaborative workshop with Jazzy Seymour back to 2009 at the Mudam in Luxembourg. It's really, really amazing museum. So basically the concept is inviting local musicians to that space and then like playing two songs each and directly recording to the cutting machine. So record fabrication starting on cutting machine, because always engraving sound into the kind of groups. So that's the first step of the like, record fabrication. And then there is no data involved, like directly cutting to plate and making master disc. And something like I have to do DIY way, like because I really want everyone to like you know creating their own like a record. So something I have done is like, just any material I can get from the shop. For example, silicone, like kind of like try to make molding on top of that. So pour into the kind of master disc, you can make negative mold from the silicone, and then like something quite simple, just like melted plastic on top of that and stamping it. And actually, you can make record like this. So shape is distorted and sound really distorted too, but still, like, you know, this principle works. And it's just one night, like kind of creating a kind of recording and also like a performance and recording and the fabrication of the record. And we actually selling record on site as well. So like try to kind of creating a kind of small like, size of the kind of music industry in that space. So it's kind of quite colorful, different colors, and actually works at record. And another project I have done is called Sound of the Earth. It's basically after this project, it's kind of I figuring out how to creating record in DIY way. So even like my level, I can creating like a record, I just realized. And something I want to try to make is, as like I lost it kind of so many data from hard drive, so I tried to creating like physical media, which can contain a lot of data. So in the beginning, kind of I'm start sketching from like kind of just, for example, like kind of spheric record and bigger side, because architecture way, like spheric is kind of must be efficient way to like kind of storing things, but actually not in the end. And it's kind of like large like record like that, and or like big like little thing. Like so many like ideas coming up. But somehow I'm really interested in like this shape, like kind of spheric shape, something intriguing me a lot. So I decided to make this project to be happen. And then this project is really difficult because it's kind of like we had to design everything, like even like record fabrication machine and record playback, and also like media itself as well. So we actually like making a really primitive prototype, and this is really early prototype and we created. And then we had to create like a recording machine. So it looks like this. So if you can get it, it's kind of basically a spheric ball has got kind of like a groove so from like spiral way, like top to end. So that's what's the idea. But as like it took like actually it took 5 years developing it because so much mechanical investigation need and also side project as well. But that time, but in the same time, that's allowed me to think about content I want to start into like that project. Because like I graduated from like Royal College Park in 2008, and I had a lot of opportunity like traveling around the world and doing some project and exhibitions. And this is my previous passport, quite a lot of stamps, and like I had to increase pages as well. Like kind of it's actually bloody like England like like immigration court stopped me for 20 minutes and checking all the like, stamps. That's kind of quite suspicious like, passport actually. And then but something I wanted to do is. Because each time I visit a new country, like I always collecting local music and bring a dictaphone, like my iPhone, and recording, like field recording as well. And I have got kind of over like visited like I think 25 to 30 different countries that time, and I have got a large collection of the sound files. And what if I can like attach this sound into that spheric record and creating sound globe map? So this is quite difficult to describe, but if you can imagine like. Sound recording start from left to top and in the end finishing like a right end, and that means that kind of you can attach sound like a scape into like actually like kind of like geographical collecting position into like a spheric record. So it's, are you getting it? What it doesn't mean? I hope like you're getting it. It's quite a complicated to describe. And but this is actually like a result. So basically this is like a record player and this kind of spiral way to recording into spheric ball. And this is kind of pick up and with stylus. And then if you see a kind of on the surface of the record, actually has got like grooves on the top. And so basically I designed sort of like a spheric like world globe map, which can like journey from North Pole to South Pole in 30 minutes. And as you see like that kind of a map, and actually like like ocean doesn't have any sound, and just only like a continent has got a sound. So that means sound like really skipping because I lay out in the geographic correct position. But surprising quite musical, so that sounds quite nice. At the moment, kind of going across around Russia or something, so you can hear national anthem in Russia. So basically, it's kind of 30-minute journey to like listening kind of whole like country's world sounds. So that's kind of one concept. And then I'm just moving to topic for another category called redesign soundscape, because as I studied at design at the Royal College of Art, and I really like, wanted to investigate like, what's the meaning of the sound into the design field. And then that's why kind of this topic came over with discussion with Anthony Dunn, like he's currently a head of the Parsons in New York and a new department. He's a really, really, truly amazing person. And then like, we discussed about how like, our surroundings hasn't really well designed as a sound. And I'm just showing one example. So like, something I want to say is, for example, like kind of alarm, it's kind of this is the beginning of the day. So what kind of sound like, you want to wake up with? And I definitely not like kind of fan of this sound. And also like talking about a bit more company, like, I don't have any critical view about Nokia because I really love like the development of the product design and also interface development is truly beautiful. But same time, like once company decided its identity sound, they never changed for like over like 10 or 20 years. And probably you're familiar with this sound. So this is actually a kind of 10 years transition of the sound of the Nokia phone sound. Actually, this music started from really beautiful like guitar music by like Francisco Tárrega, and he's Spanish like classic guitar artist, and he made like one song called Gran Vals, and really beautiful music. And however, if you have got the same like phrase for repetition, like it's became your nerve. So this original sound. Talk about is repetition, like even like a beautiful phrase, if you're like repeating, like listening into, like it just became something like kind of provoking sound, and even like this kind of formal space, like. Something fascinating about this video is kind of supposed to be classical environment, like that sound, the phrase, it should be this kind of environment. But once attached to like some reputation, like how people like annoying about that kind of sound. And also like I'm just like want to talk about like another world leading company called Apple. And they have amazing development for product design and again interaction design. But startup sound. Anyway, like once kind of decided like a really strong identity, like never ever changed. So, but I think kind of like, as thinking about kind of human logistics, like people like never like to have like a reputation. So it should be like changed like kind of frequently. And also like I'm luckily in London, like I can find so many battery design sound. And this is called Dockland Rail Service, quite new like rail line. Like I think it was made in 2006. And we can see like a dramatic bad sound design from like this public transportation.
This is Cyprus.
So this sound actually like 2,200 Hz, and this is actually like a drastically like kind of vibrating eardrum. So it shouldn't be used for like public like sound design, and. But this kind of thing, like even like kind of this kind of observation, I've just looked around, like so many things hasn't really well considered. And then something a really great design from Switzerland. And one carriage has got actually like announcement control, so you can actually change the volume. I think this street has really beautiful sound design. And then another topic is organized noise. It's part of the sound design. And again, like reputation itself, like people treat it as a kind of noise and also kind of quite provocative sound. It's actually like this is sound. Sometimes works, sometimes not. Yeah, this is only working in the mono sometimes, sorry. Maybe like that. Maybe I try to play from here. So basically, this IBM 1403 printer, and which is actually can make really, really like loud sound when you're printing something. But some really talented like programmer actually make it order into the printing process and actually making music from that. So basically, this is quite a nice way for like designing sound, because it's kind of even like a noise, but if you make order, it's actually people treat as music. And another beautiful example from Japan, it's called Melody Road, and basically it has got some texture on top of the road, and if you're driving it, that vibration can make music. And of course, I came from like product design degree at that time, and also I was looking for like how product designer and considering about sound design. And this is one of the remarkable design from like Richard Sapa. It's a design for Alessi, and it has got kettle which has two whistles, and once water is boiled, actually harmony, like this kettle making harmony of the sound. It's really beautiful object, I think. And then like I came really inspired from like this project and came up idea to creating my own like musical kettle. So this is the one. And so as you can see, like once water is boiled, actually this kettle can play your favorite music, and but still like really prototype sounds really mess. But, actually this is supposed to be Japanese famous comedy show theme, but it doesn't work at all, but I hope I can make it in the future. But I think kind of product design view, like how to physically represent in sound design, and also like reflecting to like organizing sound. So I have a really nice commission from a Danish headphone company called III. Like they asked me to creating sort of like sound sculpture, which can translate street noise into something pleasant sound. So like, this is the kind of like my proposal. So basically this is like a London taxi, obviously, has got a lot of speakers. And almost 78 different speakers and emitting quite a loud sound. And on the ceiling of the car has got really high definition microphone and can pick up street noise. So something I want to do is actually a kind of real time like driving car and picking up different street noise, and kind of obviously like London is quite a noisy city, and then like translating into some music. So a collaborator Mark McKeague, he made a really amazing program like analyzing frequency and translating into music composition. So we actually used this project and driving around London in 2012.
From Asheville, I'm Logan
Tittle.
I can hear
some sound.
How often do you try to drown out the noise of the city? Well, here's a commute that's all about translating that noise into something worth listening to. The Sound Taxi is a collaboration between artist Yuri Suzuki and headphone maker III. It started life as a standard London cab, but it's received quite the overhaul. Now it resembles something out of Pimp My Ride. The exterior of the Sound Taxi is covered in 67 different speakers, from little tweeters all the way up to enormous Indian horns that project their music for everyone to hear. But it's not as bad as you're thinking. Instead of adding to the cacophony of a downtown commute, a series of microphones built into the taxi record the horns, revving motors and whirring bikes around it, and translate it into a serene ambient soundscape in real time. Inside the cab, too, are speakers and headphones, so you can take in the music. It sounds like a pretty relaxing way to spend a commute.
So this is actually a sound coming from like an analyzation of the taxi. So we actually like emitting sound and at the same time recording and broadcasting.
The project was a promotion by III for a new line of headphones, and sadly it's now ended. But the cab isn't turning off the sound just yet. Suzuki wants to do a live show out of the back where the cab itself will add to the music. From Mashable, I'm Logan Tittle.
Thank you. kind of part of the research to be designed soundscape. And also I'm trying to move on like a different topic because I'm highly interested in the education side as well. And it's always coming from my background, like how I feel about like things. Then that's a starting point to creating something. And I'm actually dyslexic and have got quite a lot of difficulty for reading and writing. And I used to be a band when I was a teenager. It's kind of, I was quite shocking, like why did I play at this band? But surprising they're still doing it. But it's kind of a ska music band that time. I really like it that time. And I used to play trombone. And the trombone is a really interesting instrument because it's really about physical presence, like how much like arm, like between you and like, you know, position like describing about kind of notes. And so like it's kind of actually physically playing like it's like sound into sound. And then, but as my dyslexic problem, I didn't know about I'm dyslexic until like I got in like Royal College of Art. But basically trombone like musical notation looks like that. And it's impossible for me to like read that. So what I've done is always kind of put in a number of the position. I just physically learning it, like how to play trombone. But unfortunately, like that band tried to be like a professional, so I got fired like because I couldn't read a musical score. That's really sad things. You know, like it has got a lot of musical passion, but however, if you cannot read like due to dyslexic reason, you couldn't read the musical score, like you got fired from band, it's not great. So something I'm really fascinating about is kind of try to creating this like musical notation even dyslexic people could understand. And it's tied into the project called Color Chaser. So I found a really beautiful musical notation which is designed by Toru Takemitsu, and he's an amazing film music composer from Japan. And he often collaborated with graphic designers such as Bruno Munari. And it's kind of, he tried to explain as composition as a kind of, you know, like kind of like a size and also color and so on, and try to describe music as a, from the kind of visual. And the same as Mondrian, obviously, like he tried to like express music from a composition and also like kind of color. Something I started is how people can imagine the like a sound from color. So obviously, and kind of I researched quite a lot, but so many people like a darker color is lower sound and a brighter color is higher sound. That's kind of a really basic logic. And the music always has got like a duration time on each sound and the gap between sound and sound. So that's basically a main component to making music. So this is my method. So basically this black line explaining about the length of the songs. And if you interrupt with color, this white device like reading translates color information into the sound. So basically you are kind of drawing and at the same time you are composing music. So I think like, this is kind of one of the kind of fun way, but at the same time it's quite a nice way to playing music as well. And it was kind of really fast prototype, like, so programming wasn't great, but this like method is really accessible for children. So even I did quite a lot of like a workshop, like this is one in the, I think São Paulo, I did like a workshop, and they're like drawing really big picture and kind of making composition with the music. And it's more of a cooperation, it's also interesting too, collaboratively making something. And again, MUDAM in Luxembourg is a really amazing museum, asked me to develop this project a bit more. And I proposed them to like creating sort of like a collaborative platform, like so many people coming in and like playing with this device, and actually like a drawing, but same time like a jam session to creating music, and this installation. So I think during summertime, like so many people came in and drawing, and same time playing like sound. So I can show you like that installation. So it's each shape describing a defined sound content, like this is like a double step bass. And the melody is a square. And also quite important things for me is like dyslexic people like tend to not read any manual. So I think physical presence needs to describe everything. And even like sound content is described as a shape. So that's something I want to do. And I'll just like move on to the next topic of like relation with sound. A bit more this is a psychological view, how sound affects the human's behavior. So this is like a song called Gloomy Sunday by Damia. So basically this song has got a lot of like urban legend. It's causing 20 people's suicide. And in fact, like I think government in Hungary, like they forbidden to broadcast this song because of kind of, so many people committed suicide, probably caused by this song.
beau dimanche, les bras tout chargés de fleurs.
Yeah, obviously quite that kind of really gloomy and really dark song anyway, but and that time it's kind of during first war, so it's gonna be like, it's kind of can be affected to people's like emotion. But I'm really interested in like how sound is affected to the people's behavior. And one example is I'm into this one project called Child Chira. So this is a white noise and has got a lot of interesting properties. So basically, like if you use like a noise canceling headphone, it's actually emitting white noise and deleting sound. So white noise could use as sound eraser. But as and also like white noise has got another interesting property. So I'm showing you an example now.
Okay, there she is. She's crying. But then.
So if you look keyword on the YouTube, like how to calm down baby, you can see million like different videos. So many parents try to creating white noise and calm down baby. And something I want to try is kind of try to make an instrument. It's dedicated for like calm down babies, and it's called a white noise trumpet. So basically, like this sphere has got sort of a kind of structure. If you blew into this sphere, it has got a kind of shh, kind of white noise sound, and amplified with this cone. And it's supposed to be using like that, kind of when baby cried, kind of, you know, grew into that kind of baby to calm down. But at the same time, this is still a work in progress project. So it's kind of, so many parents a bit offended to use this kind of equipment. So like, I haven't really finished this project yet. And also like talking about white noise, it's as I mentioned before, it's white noise actually has got function to deleting sound. And that was back to 2009. I had the opportunity to stay at the India in New Delhi and kind of creating sort of a commission project. And I really like noise and street noise and kind of so on. Like I really, really like it. But same time, India or New Delhi is only place I couldn't stand anymore with sound. So something I wanted to do is kind of try to make like absolute quiet space. So basically, like this is inspired from Luigi Russolo, and he actually treating the kind of noise as a kind of part of the music. It's called art of noise. And something I want to do a bit more opposite, kind of this shape taken from this his shape, but any sound coming in, actually like white, same amount of white noise reflecting, I try to deleting sound. But in the end, this short project, it became kind of a bit like too late for it. That was kind of only like 1 week production, so sophisticated, not sophisticated result, but still quite interesting like installation. And then I've just moved on to the final topic. It's kind of a bit more educational side. I'm organizing quite a lot of workshop and also kind of developing like workshop tools and material. And like transparent box, it's actually nothing really related to sound this time, but I kind of came from like my dyslexic experience. I'm doing quite a lot of technical project, but unfortunately, I cannot really program or like doing physical computing at all, and because I really don't know how to do it, and sometimes kind of mathematics mess me up, like couldn't really understand things. But that's kind of really important part because like now it's kind of your iPhone, or like your like computer has got like you can do multiple tasks, but at the same time nobody can describe what's happening inside of the computer. So like transparent box means kind of opposite word of the black box, like try to make understand what's inside and what is the component, how system work. And this project called Breakfast Machine was commissioned like from like a museum in Amsterdam. And they asked me to conducting sort of final event and kind of sharing knowledge. So something I really want to do is kind of like how mechanical and how system and how logistical things work. and try to like developing ideas how to like making mechanical construction from this project. So I propose them to creating a breakfast machine, because this kind of difficult task, but same time not far-fetched task to make it happen with machines. So something kind of I collected so many like different films with different scenes from like kind of like a breakfast machine scene from different films, like this is from a flower from a Disney. Doing apparently good at breakfast machine. And also this is P.V. Hammond, and probably most famous like breakfast machine in the world. It's really beautifully made, but the system it really doesn't work. This is from Tiki Tiki Bam Bam. It's one of the really well made mechanical structure from Disney. And apparently, yeah, of course, Back to the Future, and also Wallace and Gromit.
This morning, Gromit.
I like a 3 minute egg.
Well, steady on. Wow! Gromit! Oh!
So a little bit of inspiration, and it's everything not to do too far-fetched thing. So, and in the beginning, we had to collect materials, and the material should be something you're familiar with. So we basically went to flea market in Amsterdam and collecting so much different like material. And then we actually, like, this cooperative project, so many people must participate to finishing this project. And actually we put some advertisement on the Design Boom, it's widely lead blog. And actually, like, we put all material on the power tools, the central part of the exhibition space. And actually, like, 2 weeks, many people coming in and can try and error to making the breakfast machine. So, for example,
ready, like, steady, go.
Damn,
why didn't it work?
So each time giving them like some brief, like how to making like egg, like a cracking machine and so on. And they make a really primitive prototype. And me and like collaborator Masaki Mura making it better shape.
Yeah. Oh.
So that was kind of like over like I think 200 people coming in and kind of tried to help when children came as well, and finally I made a really large installation. So it's almost like kind of I think 23 meter by 2.5 meters, like a really large installation. And unfortunately, I can't really show video because not so much time left. But if you see a kind of section like here, it's in the beginning a kind of egg cracking machine and making coffee, and also a kind of slicing bread and so on. It's everything kind of supposed to be automatic as well. So we invited all people like around, you know, like who helped this project, and we served like kind of breakfast a whole day. And unfortunately, we had to like kind of take down this installation because kind of not so much space left, because obviously this museum had to close down right after the project. So we actually like taken over and kind of throwing away most of things. But it became kind of big news in the kind of 2 months later. It was on the kind of Daily Telegraph and the Metro, Hindu Times, or like something like Chinese like a newspaper as well. And I've got so much like different kind of inquiry after that. And also another project based on the transparent box is called TuneMap Radio. So that was a mechanical system. Like I want to do like a bit more open up that people to understand. And I had the opportunity in like 2012, I think, in the Design Museum commissioned me to creating a series of objects actually reflecting to how to describing system in the world. And then it's actually like I'm looking on the kind of PCB. It's called a printed circuit board. It's probably common. Like most common way to producing electronics products is really efficient and really cheap to produce it. But same time, problem is kind of such a complicated. Like even me, like I have limited knowledge about electronics, but I never ever understand this. Then I was thinking like, how I can design like something like much more clearer to people to understand. And then I'm looking on a kind of PCB board, and same time like looking at tube map in London. It looks like circuit board. And then I was thinking like if I can combine like this like layout of the like a PCB board into like implement into the kind of spread into the kind of something you're familiar with, because I'm commuting to the kind of like pressed, and I know like how to commute, how to change as well. So like if you replace with something you're familiar with, probably you have a better understanding. And then I came up with the idea to creating an FM radio. It's based on the layout of the TuneMap. So it's called TuneMap Radio. And it's not only about layout, it's actually put component related to the city function. And for example, like tuner is BBC, and also speaker corner is volume, and also battery is Battersea Power Station, and also Alexander Palace is antenna. So something iconic and something related to the function as well. And something really good to discover is Harry Beck. He's the original designer of the London Tube Map. He actually designed that format of Tube Map in London Underground. He actually used to be an electrician, and he actually designed like London Tube Map based on the electric diagram. So this is his early sketch of the London Tube, and actually he put so much like words like us and also amplifier. So he tried to link with like London cities as electronics as well. So I think that's kind of one of the nice way to, like story-wise, really combine really well. So I think move on to like next project called Dentac AutoTour, because after this, I really wanted to creating a platform like everyone can use, and also easy to use, and also kind of like basically understand basic physics of the product, electricity and the programming as well. And this project, the collaboration work with like Dentac is a company I used to run with another partner called Mark McKeague. And then, like this AutoTour, it's really, really primitive platform. Like has got capacitive sensitive touchpad. Like it looks like kind of keyboard basically, and the keyboard basically has got like so many like different switches. And I'm just like describing as a kind of video. Like probably like this describing much more well. So it looks like kind of keyboard and synthesizer, and you can change sound. There's like 50 different sounds inside. But if you connect with like any conductive object such as water or a kind of plant and maybe spoon, that's also conductive. And also banana, obviously. So if you connect it, you can trigger sound. And also you can connect with like a different sensor, like such as light sensor, pressure sensor as well. And you can change sound from like a surrounding. So actually we have got kind of an AutoTune in here, so I can just like, quickly demonstrate this one. Sorry, I think I need to connect one more thing. Okay. So you can change sound. So it has been quite great. Like, thank you. Thank you. This has been quite good feedback from like kind of as educational tools, like basically like we did like a lot of workshop from this product, and so basically like we conducted one workshop with a student from like ECAL in the college in Switzerland, and they're a product design student and didn't have so much knowledge about programming, but they quickly came up with really amazing concept, making really beautiful installations. And also like a mechanical drum machine like some student made. So making music of, like a basketball as well. So thank you. something I want to do is kind of like these days electronic music instruments developing a lot, even like people customize and like making new musical instruments, but they need a lot of knowledge about programming. He's Darius, he's an amazing musician as well as a great interface maker. He makes really amazing controller to playing music. But what if like Jess from New Girl, like that kind of girl has got amazing talent for the music, but what kind of creation can make it? So basically, like ideas came from company partner, Mark McKee's like girlfriend. He really afraid to touch any PCB board or electronics. Basically, scared about it. But something like kind of like illustration, kind of describing itself, and it looks really friendly circuit board. So basically, like, I didn't want to put any words. Like just like if you are following like passage, like you can know like kind of like barely like kind of understanding like function. And also, like this is kind of looks like a roadmap. So, like if you see like, a roadmap, you can following that, you can see the function. So, I'm just moving on to like next project. It's called AR Music Kit, and that's also kind of like, try to make a development for the some platform for education as well. So, this is a collaboration with Google Data Team. It's a really, really awesome team to creating amazing project. Like for example, like they like recently like they have like a 3D like a drawing. And also like so many like installation for the museum as well, and they asked me to collaborate to develop some project, and then the kind of like nice things about data team like kind of Takashi and Jeff, like they lead creative for the team, is they have children and they're really really interested in developing the sort of like tools that can use for children as well. And something really fascinating about things kind of AR, augmented reality, and always applications obvious game on the visual side. Something I want to do like really easy to use, and it's kind of like for example, like probably you imagine like it used to be like you playing like kind of looks like kind of playing guitar with a tennis racket and so on, and also air guitar is obviously quite popular. But and also like as well as kind of making a culture of kind of DIY things, making like primitive. Musical instruments quite popular as well, and a really beautiful aesthetic and a really good for education as well. But same time, like problem is always sound quality is not that great.
Now you can tune the rubber bands by making them tighter or looser around the box. Oh, that's lovely!
But it's like nothing really well tuned or anything. So that's why I came up with an idea called quite easy to use, and using augmented reality or augmenting sound with you or something you are made with. It's called AR Music Kit.
AR Music Kit, one of Yuri Suzuki's most recent audio adventures, is a technology that enables you to create a unique DIY musical experience using just your camera phone and some paper. Here's how it works. When the code or marker is picked up by the camera, the app translates it into a musical note and plays it back to you. Suzuki's Music Kit allows anyone with a smartphone to access a creative platform with which to make music in an unexpected and unusual way. Using this app, we can turn anything into a virtual instrument. Take the guitar, for example. Simply prepare the markers and attach them to any material, then cover the chord that you want to play and strum the guitar marker. The piano works in a similar way. Attach the relevant markers anywhere at all, and using your phone, you can play piano as you like. Finally, we have the music box. Create a musical pattern by organizing the markers in a certain way, any way you like. Then listen as the camera picks up the pattern and plays your tune. This technology has fantastic potential in developing do-it-yourself culture, empowering people to explore, create, and take control of their own musical experiences. No need for practice. Cut, stick, and play.
So this is kind of like I'm just like demonstrate now, because basically something you need is only paper. Like this, and you just have to stick on like anything like primitive like guitar I just made yesterday, and then like just attach it on top of that. And if you see the screen in here, can you switch to this one? Yeah, can you see it? So basically, like recognizing, it's kind of light is too strong here. it's really like strong writing here, so it's quite difficult to demonstrate, but if you can imagine. And you can play like guitar, and also you can change like sound as well. Like, and also, it's not only guitar, you can like actually use different marker, like do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, si things. And then like I just have to change into different like mode. It's called piano. So if I put in like anything. It's so difficult. Okay, maybe so. So you can play like different sound as well. Thank you. Okay. So basically, like these tools can be quite nice as I think this is platform is not only for children. Like for example, elderly people like even using this one to like kind of like a passion for like making and also like kind of creating like music as well. And also, this is like an Android experiment, part of the Android experiment project in Google. And it's totally open source. You can download, and if you want to modify, you can do it as well. So final part is I just want to talk about a bit more about the installation things, but I'm just probably I can only introduce one project. It's called Robot for Music Video. So as well as I'm working for the client and directing video and making things, and this project actually like co-directing and working with like Masashi Kawamura. I think he was here like kind of a couple of years ago. And it's really nice brief I've got because he wanted like a direct video, which is actually robot is dancing and kind of especially robot is designed for the music, and that's actually like making like a music video. And this is actually my favorite video since I was a child. It's by the Harvey Hancock Rocket. So basically, robot is dancing and kind of telling up a story about the music. So this is something of my favorite like, music video when I was a child, and this kind of almost dream project came to me. So it started from a really, really primitive drawing, and like working with kind of Masashi as well, and kind of creating like, really different shapes and so on, and also the kind of 3D rendering, and also kind of making a kind of confirmation how like, things move and so on. So bit more like between engineering and design as well. And more about the kind of final shape of this kind of object, what kind of like, object going to be dancing in the music. And it's kind of in the beginning, kind of layouting into kind of 3D space and on the desk. And the most difficult part is production always, because mechanical things, it's really difficult to make it. And I have been working with like Masaki Mura, and he's currently like a director at Tasco in the Japanese company, and Tomoaki Yanagisa from Rizomatics. It's really, really amazing people to working with. And finally, we made 13 different robots, and it's actually a kind of like this size. We're actually placing on top of like a desk. And something important, these music videos and the choreography and those light effects have to link with like music. So we're actually using like language called like MIDI. It's really common music signal and for the controlling electronic musical instrument. Okay, so thank you so much. And it's only 1 minute left. So thank you.
I knew a young girl who was paralyzed from a car accident. She used to be a drummer, and I was just thinking, have you ever considered using your inventions to help those who are paralyzed from accidents?
Yeah, I think something kind of try to design things more about kind of any therapy and any like, kind of recovering session. Like need to have like something tactile and also something feeling, because you obviously have to use a lot of sense to recovering things, like kind of five sense basically. So something I really want to do is kind of always kind of using a lot of like sense as possible. So not only visual and also sound as well, sometimes like feeling or from kind of, you know, haptics feeling as well. So I think like I'm not sure kind of it's really help, but if anything can help, it would be great. Sorry, like, I'm not really like appropriately like answer your question, I think.
Regarding to your previous works that you have tried to create sounds and try to identify human emotion after listening to these sounds, ultimately, what is your ambition to do these experiments?
I think really important. I don't have a kind of strong like kind of output or anything at the moment. More about part of research as well. But once I have got pile of like research regarding like a relation between human emotion, and actually I'm currently working with Kingston College and talking with psychologist and how sound is affected the human. And I think I'm trying to writing book for next 1 year about how sound design should be. And it should be kind of quite useful for the kind of people like fascinating about sound and the kind of redesigning sound as well. So output could be a book, I think.
After watching Tokyo 2020 Olympics trailer, that Shinzo Abe was dressed as Mario, if you have a chance to design opening title of Tokyo 2020 Olympics, what sound will you design?
I don't
Please
know.
Hum.
I think already. Like, yeah, but in Japan already has a brilliant company called Rhizomatics, and they, I feel like kind of they're gonna do an amazing job. But if I can design, like also like kind of concert with strong strengths of the sound as well, because obviously like if you see like a closing ceremony at the Rio Olympic, and they use a lot of like Mario and the Super Mario reference as a sound as well, and it's not really recognizable. But once you find it, it's actually really amazing effect you can get. So something I would think differently think about kind of sound context, what representing Japan from like sound.
You are a sound expert. What fascinates you about noise, and what age did you become interested in sound? Do you have a favorite kind of music? So that's actually three questions in one.
Yeah, I think that's great because I think like first of all, noise. Like if you have got absolute quiet pace, you feel really like dizzying and it's really uncomfortable. So it's neat to have a sort of a noise always, like a background, and also like fascination. Basically, like my father he's amazing like a record collector, and he has got everything. Like basically, if I ask for like, do you have like this kind of music, he always can pick up from his like cabinet and kind of some record as well. And even he's really interested in like any music. Like he was really into Marilyn Manson 5 years ago. Or something. Really, really amazing guy. And I think fascination came from his music influence. And yes, so something I kind of really nice to asking you is kind of because something I'm really interested in urban music, like music coming from the like city and so on, and like dance music, for example, like in London used to have a quite amazing culture of dance music, such as like a dubstep or like a grime. That is actually a kind of culturally like merging into like one city, the making of new culture, and also like Indonesia as well. Like there's one specific genre called funky kota. And also Rio de Janeiro, they have got music called Baile Funky. So just wondering, in like Bangkok or Thailand, like are there any specific like urban, like new music